What's up, lovers of whiskey and watchers of YouTube? I'm the Malt Activist, and in this video, I'm going to tell you about my favorite whiskies at various price points. Sounds good? Let's do it. Before we begin, a big fat thank you to our first time viewers. Thank you for clicking through on that thumbnail. That means you like whiskey. And if you like whiskey, then this channel is the one for you. You know, consider subscribing because you are going to get an amazing variety of content from this channel, whiskey related. Whiskey lists, whiskey reviews, whiskey rants, whiskey discussions, whiskey vlogs, and everything in between. So, what are you waiting for? Just do it! Just do it! To my returning viewers, thank you for keeping your standards low and the fact that you keep coming back to this channel. It means a lot and it warms the cockles of my heart when I see that. So thank you so much. And of course, to my YouTube members and my Patreon gang, man, you guys are the best. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's highly appreciated. Okay, on with the video. Okay, for this video, I kind of kept it as simple as I could. The criteria was I have to have had tasted this whiskey, and I thought that was really, really important. So I've tasted all these whiskeys that I'm about to share with you. My research is, as usual, from UK online retail stores. And again, the reason for that is I find prices so varied. If I go to North America, US has its own, you know, individual state laws, prices and taxes are so different that it's very hard for me to get like a median price for a particular whiskey that I'm looking at. So UK online retailers like Master of Malt, the Whiskey Exchange, you know, to name a few, those are my sort of key reference sites that I go and find out these prices. By the way, prices are going up. I don't understand why. Oh, so bad. Anyway, besides the point, this is not a rant video. This is just, I think it's gonna turn into one, but I don't wanna get there. Anyway, so I narrowed down some price points. We start with 20 pounds because I realized anything less than 20 pounds, well, you might as well just drink Kool-Aid or whatever, or Iron Brew. Yes, for anything less than 20 pounds, just drink Iron Brew. Don't worry about whiskey. Though there are some good bourbons, but I thought, you know, maybe that's a list for another day. So our price points are 20 to 30, 30 to 40, so on and so forth, going up to 100 pounds. And within that price range, I've picked whiskeys that I've personally tasted that I think, wow, within that price range, that's my favorite whiskey. Now, do I consider some of them slightly overpriced? Yes, sure, I do. However, it is what it is. I don't set the prices. I merely inform, okay? So, there you have it. There you have it. My favorite whiskeys at various price points. Let's go. Let's do this. Let's do this. All right, Loch Lomond Inchmurrin, 12 years old, coming in at about 28 pounds roughly. I mean, dude, that is a fantastic price for what I think is a fantastic whiskey. It has an age statement. It's bottled at about 46% ABV, matured in bourbon barrels, and very freely available. You know what I'm saying? And if you remember, I did a video maybe like a month or so ago where I compared the Inchmurrin with the Inchmoan, which is the peated version of the Loch Lomond 12, and we did a comparison and whatever. And I gotta tell you, man, I've increasingly becoming more and more impressed with the stuff Loch Lomond is doing, and the fact that you can get a 12-year-old age statement whiskey at 46% ABV for under 30 pounds. I mean, that's crazy. In today's day and age, I think that's absolutely crazy. And it's a great whiskey on top of that, right? You know, you're not compromising. It's a good, solid dram. It's a good, solid dram, flavor-wise, quite sweet. It has some cereal notes, allspice, toffee, apple, pears, and that wonderful caramel right at the end. So, if you're stuck and you're broke, but you still want your whiskey fix, then I highly suggest the Loch Lomond 12 Inchmurrin. That will set you back only 28 pounds, which I think is a fantastic deal. I thought of the Old Pultany 12, but then you know what? I chose the Loch Lomond 12 in favor of that because of the higher ABV, and I think 46% ABV is a fantastic strength at this price for this bottle with an age statement. So you know what? I don't think you can go wrong with this. Right, so that's our pick for our 20 to 30 pound price bracket. Our next whisky in our 30 to 40 pound bracket cost about £35, and it was my whisky of the year last year. I'm of course talking about the Ledaig 10-year-old. I'm in love with Ledaig. And this 10-year-old, oh, just everything perfect about it. It just fits all my preferred flavor profiles. I love it so much. For those of you who don't know, I'm going to tell this story really, really quickly. About 5 or 6 years ago, I don't remember when, I got invited to a Ledaig 42 tasting. And that was supposed to be the highlight of the evening. Of course it was. It was £3,500 a bottle. But before that, before we got to the big show, we were given these little paltry appetizers like the Ledaig 10, which we drank that day. And I remember thinking, holy shit, what is this? It was amazing. It was better than the Ledaig 42, in my opinion. And when the waiters were going around asking, hey, do you want refills? Everyone was going for the 18-year-old or the 15-year-old or whatever. I don't even remember what's on the menu. I think I was the only one who was like, you know what? I think I'll have another sample of the Ledaig 10. And the waiter looked at me like, are you not aware of what's on the menu? You know? And he gave me a slightly quizzical look, but you know what? The Ledaig 10 for me stood out so fantastically well that evening. Absolutely love it. What do we know about it? We know that it is bottled at 46.3% ABV, as are all the Bernstewart whiskies from that portfolio, including Boonehaven. So 46.3% ABV on this baby, matured in bourbon barrels, and in terms of flavor profile, we're looking at a beautiful soft peat. That smoke, that barley, that oily walnut, dried fruit, charred oak, and that black pepper at the end. Just everything so good about this whiskey. I really, really like it. And again, at £35, no brainer. In my opinion, this is a no brainer, and definitely my favorite whiskey within this price point. Get it, buy it, get it. All right, let's go. All right, moving up the ladder between the 40, 50 pound price bracket. I'm talking about this gorgeous Port Charlotte 10 years old. Man, I remember when I opened up this bottle for the first time, it's about 2-3 years ago, and I drank it and I was like, oh, this is what good old fashioned, old school Ardbegs must have tasted like, because it was just sublime. And I absolutely loved it. I have a bottle sitting up on my shelf right there, beautiful Port Charlotte 10. Just amazing flavor profile, bottled at a lovely 50% ABV. It has a lovely mix of maturation. You have first fill American, refill American, and then a French oak. I won't go into the ratios, they're a bit whatever. Lovely flavor profile. We're talking salted caramel, sea air, by the water, love it. Custard cream, white grapes, ginger, and that rye toast right at the end. Man, I gotta tell you, this is one of my quintessentially favorite whiskey out from Bruichladdy, Port Charlotte. And just such a good job on this one. No off notes, wonderfully constructed. That spirit is just beautiful. Those casks are pristine. And then the blending, oh, that whiskey making. That's what I'm talking about, man. The Port Charlotte 10 at £45 is just, again, a no-brainer. A beautiful whiskey at a great price, in my opinion, with just the best flavor profile that you can ask for, you know? I still sort of drift off when I think about the first time I drank it. Such a good whiskey, that. Buy it, get it. You love it. All right, 50 to 60 pounds. And frankly, I think we could have included this in the previous category as well, because this one sits at an even 50 pounds retail. I'm talking about the Ardnamurchan 8009 2022 Cask Strength. Yes, man, I love the stuff Ardnamurchan is doing. I think it's the hottest new distillery right now, more than Bimber in my opinion. Ardnamurchan is doing some really, really great stuff. I think better than Cotswold also, in my opinion. Just wonderfully constructed whiskey, you know, and again, it's that attention to detail on the spirit and the distillate, right? And then if you can just, like I said, in the previous example, if you can just make sure that your casks are pristine and there's nothing off about those casks, and your storage conditions are good, and you have a good master blender who can put these spirits together and bottle them. Ardnamurchan is, in my opinion, doing almost everything right. And it is evident from the whiskies that we're drinking. It's absolutely amazing. So, what do we know about this? Bottled at 58.4% ABV. It's a mix of bourbon and sherry casks. In terms of flavor profile, we're looking at a maritime smoke. Huh? Very, very gentle maritime smoke. Lots of vanilla, lemon zest, berries, pepper. There's a gentle peat right at the end somewhere, and a hint of brininess that just rounds off what I think is an amazing drinking experience from a distillery that everyone needs to look out for. I'm gonna tell you, man, these bottles are going to be worth their weight in gold very, very soon. The second these boys start coming out with these age statement with the age statements, it's going to be great. Yes, so the Ardnamurchan at £50, what a steal. What a steal because of the flavor profiles. You getting a cask strength whiskey, can't go wrong. Go ahead, find it, buy it, drink it, you know. Stop, hit pause on this video, go buy the Ardnamurchan cask strength, and then come back and then resume. All right, let's do it. All right, I guess only the rich folk remaining now, because we're now hitting the 60 to 70 price point. At £64, is probably my favorite whiskey ever in the history of whiskey drinking, is of course the Laphroaig 10-year-old cask strength series. And in this case, I'm talking about the batch 15, which I think is the latest one, available at for £64. And man, what's there to say about the Laphroaig 10 cask strength series that has not already been said by so many people? Sorry, I'm banging shit on my table. It's perfect. It's near perfect. Near perfect, you know? Just, again, first fill, bourbon, barrels, just, oh, everything so good about it. Oh man, I can't even begin to tell you. This one is bottled at 56.5% ABV and matured exclusively in first fill bourbon barrels. Flavor profile wise, we're talking, oh, that iodine. Oh, that Laphroaig iodine. Smoke, candied fruits, toffee, clove, salted caramel, black currant, and licorice. All the quintessential Laphroaig aromas and flavors in this bottle. Man, I remember when I came across the Laphroaig 10 cask strength series. I think they were at batch 4 at that time. So maybe about 10 years ago, I wanna say. And I remember drinking it, and I'm like, oh my God, this is it. Peat and the smoke and the iodine and at cask strength, oh man. And then I went crazy and I was like, oh my God, if there's a batch 4, there must be a batch 1, 2, 3. And I had to go find it, and I did. And then, I don't know if you can see over there, can you? Maybe not, I don't know, it's a little out of frame. Yep, those are all my Laphroaig 10 cask strength series from batch 1 to batch 15, because, you know, I have a disease. I have a disease, there's nothing I can do about it. But anyway, if you want to spend £64 and you want to drink probably my most favorite whiskey ever in the world, then I suggest the Laphroaig 10 cask strength batch 15. Oh, so good. So good. Gotta get it. I mean, of course you have to get it. You'd be stupid not to get it. Get it. We are now in the 70 to 80 price bracket, and which means only Richard Branson, Elon Musk, and the Sultan of Brunei are left watching this video, because we have hit the big time, ladies and gentlemen. No, actually, just gentlemen. If you look at my analytics, it's 100% men watching, with maybe one lady, I think. Anyway, I'm of course talking about the Deanston 18-year-old. This one is available to you for £74. And the Deanston 18, oh man, I gotta tell you, I did a review of the Deanston 18 a few months ago. And I actually discovered it at a tasting for my whiskey club where we were tasting only 18-year-old whiskeys. And among a lot of 18-year-olds, we had the Deanston 18. Everyone tasted it blind. And this one came out as a strong winner. And I gotta tell you, man, Deanston, along with Loch Lomond, is doing some fantastic work. Deanston stuff is mwah. They know what they're doing. They're on this trajectory, which is super exciting, and I think everyone should look out for them. And I think they're doing some absolutely fantastic work. And this Deanston 18-year-old is testament to that amazing skill that these guys have. It's just, get it, man. What do we know about this? This is 46.3% ABV bourbon barrel. Oh yes, of course, this is Burn Stewart. They're knocking it out of the park, man. They're knocking it out of the park. So yeah, sorry, what was I saying? Yes, bottled at 46.3% ABV, matured exclusively in bourbon barrels. Flavor profile, we're talking earthy vanilla, sweet melon, lemon, lime, orange sweets, candied ginger, honey, walnuts, and that beautiful malted barley right at the end. Oh man, I remember drinking this for the first time, maybe like a year ago, and going, oh yes. This is why I do it. This is why I drink the whiskeys that I drink. It's so that I can find these treasures. And it was such an amazing feeling to get so many of my whiskey club members to be like, oh wow, we've just discovered a gem. And now, you know, they all went out and bought their own bottles and it was awesome. And dude, this is probably one of the best whiskeys floating around right now. And yeah, sure, it's at 74 pounds, but it is 18 years old. You know, there's a hefty age statement to it. So I still think, all things considered, not a bad price to be at. Still, not a bad price to be at. So for 74 pounds, this Deanston 18 gets my tick of approval. So if you're Mr. Moneybags and you have 74 pounds to spend on a bottle of whiskey, then make it the Deanston 18. I promise you, you will not be disappointed. £80 to £90, welcome Jeff Bezos. Thank you for sticking around, Elon. The Sultan of Brunei has already left. That's just, I guess, the two of you only watching, because wow, nobody's ever seen that much money before in their lives, have they? Anyway, so for, what are we looking at? For £83, you can get your hands on the Speyburn 18. Yes, the Speyburn 18. I probably get the most comments about Speyburn 15 and 18 on my videos to try. And the other day, I was lucky enough to sit down with a friend of mine who had a bottle of this. I drank it. I thought it was fantastic. I, in fact, sampled some back to drink it in my spare time. And I gotta tell you, I was not disappointed. Fantastic dram, the Speyburn 18, bottled at 46%. It's a mix of American and Spanish oak with flavor profiles. Oh, I love this flavor profile, by the way. Toffee, sugared almonds, tropical fruits, dark chocolate, citrus, honey, and just the tiniest, wispiest hint of smoke right at the end. Man, dude. This Speyburn 18, such an underrated whiskey, such an underrepped whiskey. I think it's probably the diehards that really know about this, and I think we need to speak more about the Speyburn collection, even the 15, 18, they're fantastic whiskeys, and I think you should get your hands on them, especially this 18-year-old. And, you know, Jeff, Elon, if you're still there, £83, I know it's a lot of money for you guys, but I think it's worth spending on this 18-year-old Speyburn, because the drinking experience is just... Mwah. Beautiful, beautiful. $9,200, holy shit. That is, wow. I think we've crossed the stratosphere of, I think we're in Uncle Scrooge territory now, aren't we? Damn. Yes, for £98, I'm going to recommend the AnCnoc 18-year-old. Yes. Now, I'm going to be very honest with you. I really did not find Let's just put it this way. AnCnoc was not my first choice for this category. There were some that were outside the 100-pound mark, and there were some that were below the 90-pound mark. So the AnCnoc was not my first choice, but within this price bracket is the only one that I could identify, which I thought was worthy of making this list. Look how pompous I am. Worthy of making this list. No, it's not that. It's just that I think there are better whiskies that are closer to price range. So for example, the AnCnoc 18 is 98 pounds, but for 110, 112, you can get something else. And for obviously slightly less than 90 pounds, you can get other whiskies as well. But within this price bracket of 90 to 100, I thought the AnCnoc 18 was probably my most obvious choice. And again, look, I'm not knocking the whiskey. I think it's a great whiskey. Bottled at 46% ABV, a mix of Spanish sherry and American bourbon barrels. In terms of flavor profile, it's very, very, very fruity, spicy, dried fruit, baking spices, ripe oranges, candied lemon, honey, caramel, and that vanilla. So, you know, kind of ticking all the boxes. But I think there are better whiskeys out there if you spend another 10 pounds or save another 10, if you know what I mean, you know? But still, within this price bracket, I think the AnCnoc 18 is a great pick. And listen, man, if you want to spend that kind of money on a single bottle of whiskey, then probably AnCnoc 18 is not a bad choice. Though if I were you, I'd probably buy two bottles of the Ardnamurchan Cask Strength at 50 pounds if I'm going to spend 100 pounds. So that's just my opinion. So 90 to 100 pound price point, I think the AnCnoc 18 should serve you well, even though if it was not my first choice for this price range, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not 100% behind the AnCnoc 18 on this one, but within this price range, I think it's a decent whiskey to buy if you're going to spend that kind of money. Do you know where I'm coming from? I hope you understand where I'm coming from. And there you have it, man. There you have it. All these whiskeys at this price point. I think it's a good exercise to do. Everyone has budgets, as do I, you know, and sometimes you're like, you know what, I don't want to spend more than 60, 70 pounds for a whiskey. What's the best purchase I can make for that price? And I think, you know, having a list like this is important, just for a frame of reference, if you know what I mean, you know. Obviously, look, I'm sure there are other whiskeys out there within these price points that didn't make the list, and quite possibly the reason that they didn't make the list is because I haven't drunk them, you know? So if there are whiskeys out there in these price points that I missed out, man, put them down in the comments below. I'll have a look, and if I can get my hands on them and taste them, I'll probably make another video similar to the one like this. But yeah, man, I hope this one helped. I like pointing people in the right direction. I like helping people sort of save on their money and hopefully make right choices when buying whiskey, because, you know, I bite the bullet for you guys, and that's why you're here, because, you know what I mean, right? You know, I bite the bullet, you drink, just, it's okay, I got you. Okay, so this was fun, and thank you for sticking around, and like I said, I don't think there's any good way to end a video, so, you know, until next time, I'm the Malt Activist.